Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another vlog. In today's video, we are going to get crafty. We are going to get DIY-y. We're going to have a lot of fun in today's video because we are going to be creating 4 different neutral, aesthetic, chic wall art pieces on a budget. I showed on my Instagram, I created a reel of the wall art that I made for our hallway. You all went crazy over that. So I was like, you know what? I feel like I can come up with a few more. If you like these type of videos, if you're interested in seeing more DIYs on my channel, let me know. Give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe. And if you're ready to get crafty with me, then please just keep on watching. It's all back home. We're about to start the DIYs. I'm really, really excited. We're gonna start with the black, I guess imprinted art. I don't know exactly what to call this, but this one's my favorite. I'm really excited about this. It's super easy. All you're gonna need is basic acrylic paint in black, or really whatever color you wanna use. Even just like a white creamy color, but I'm using black. And then you're gonna need one of these little spatulas, a paintbrush. I got my paintbrushes right here. I got some new ones for you all to be fancy. And then to make the imprinted texture, you're going to need this mixing medium, which I'm not a pro at DIY, so mixing medium sounds really technical and like intimidating, but I promise it's not. You just have to mix it with the paint and it makes a texture, and then you like dab it on, you guys. It's super easy. So this is what you need. So let's get started. You can see it's all painted. That literally took me 6 minutes and 30 seconds of filming. Really quick, really easy. Now we just wait for it to dry overnight and then we can start making the little imprints. Okay, you guys, so clearly it is the next day and our canvas here is nice and dry. It's looking crisp, it's looking good, it's looking professional, and we're gonna make it look a little bit better. So first thing we're gonna do is mix in the acrylic mixing medium with some black paint, and then you're gonna get that imprint texture that we want. So I'm gonna go ahead and mix this up. I'm just gonna mix it in this little thing. Whatever you have is fine. I'm just gonna scoop it out with this spatula. I guess, is this a spatula?
It looks like a spatula.
I mean, it's like a little mini spatula. So we're gonna take our little baby mini spatula, scoop some out, dab it on the canvas, and literally with the back of this, you're just gonna press it in to the canvas. So let's do this. Okay, you guys, so this is kind of the consistency you want. It's the texture of Jell-O pudding almost, but a little bit thick. It's like really thick pudding, like it barely comes off. That's what you want it to be like, so that it can really make like a 3D raised imprint. It's supposed to look like this. Yeah. Boop. That should be the consistency. Stop. This is why we can't do no DIYs on this channel. Okay, you guys, so this is what it looks like all finished. It's not dry yet, so what you wanna do is after you get to this point is let it dry for, I let mine dry for 24 hours just because how thick it is, like it takes a while to dry. So just let it dry for 24 hours and then you can hang up your beautiful masterpiece. I'm obsessed with this one. Okay, you guys. So for this next wall art piece, I have never done this before. We're gonna be working with joint, well, okay, you're supposed to, which all the directions online said, work with joint compound. We have that, but it's at my mom's house. I'm not going over there. So we're just gonna use what we have in the house, and that is dry decks. What is this, spackling? You guys, it looks like this. It's for projects around the house. Rob uses it. Basically, it's like this thick texture. You spread it on the canvas, make your own type of texture and design, and then you can paint over it, or you can just leave it this color if you want. I'm pretty sure it dries even more white than this. We're gonna try this. I'm trying this for the first time with you guys, so we'll see. I have a good feeling though. I'm gonna use this like putty knife. I'm probably getting the terms wrong. Ooh, this is thick. Okay, we're gonna see how this goes. I'm literally going to scoop it out, spread it around, make texture on this canvas art. If not, this could be a blooper and I'll have to actually get joint compound tomorrow. But I figured since I'm here, we're filming, I mean, I'm dressed, I had my makeup on, so it's like I might as well try it out. Okay, here we go. This is super thick. Oh my gosh, I don't know how this is gonna go. Okay guys, so I'm literally just spreading it on and it's not really giving what it's supposed to give. I'm gonna keep at it, like every time I spread it. Guys, I don't know about this one. Okay, I don't know if you can see this, but like it's making the texture, but it's also kind of peeling up. I don't know if I should continue. Like, see, it's literally peeling. Okay, so remember when I said this might be part of the bloopers? This is the bloopers. Welcome to the bloopers. This did not work out. You live and you learn. We learned. We're not gonna do that. I'm going to go to my mom's house tomorrow and get the actual joint compound, what you're supposed to use. Don't buy this. Okay, you guys, so it is the next day. I have my canvas right here. I've got my joint compound. Shout out to my mom for bringing it over. I've got some tools. We have this basic tool right here that you normally use with this product. And then I also have this ice scraper because I thought the back of it might be able to put like a really cool design. So we shall see. Let's do this. Part two, I have a good feeling. So this is what the art piece is looking like. I just have it over here in this corner to dry. I really like the natural color of it. I know it's gonna dry down a lot lighter, but anyway, this is what it looks like. I'm loving it. Let's move on to the next one. Guys, so it is a brand new day and it is time for textured wall art piece number three. For this one, we're gonna use our joint compound again since we know that works way better. We're gonna use our joint compound and just evenly spread it on the canvas just to give some texture, but we're not really gonna create a design. We're just gonna keep it super simple. This is probably the easiest one because we're gonna be mixing paints together and creating just like a neutral kind of gray brownie shade. You all know I'm all about the tone. So of course it's gonna be tonal, but you can pick any color that you want that's gonna complement your space. I picked up a bunch of different colors at Michael's. Everything that I purchased is from Michael's. So we're just gonna mix some colors together. After the joint compound has dried, we're gonna paint it. And I really wanna focus just kind of on the middle of the canvas and leave the rim around the canvas white without any texture on it. So yeah, you guys, let's get started. Bree, how long have you been? Bree! I didn't even notice Bree was here, you guys. Mom life. Thank you.
Okay, you guys, so this is what the third and final piece is looking like. Well, we're not done, it's not finalized, but this is what the last one we're making looks like. Once it is dry, we can paint over it, but I left the rim around here bare because I just wanna do a different effect with the paint tomorrow. So let's let this dry and we'll be back. Guys, so this is what it's looking like all painted. I just love how textured it looks. Even with using the sponge, it added texture, but the joint compound, double texture. We're gonna wait for this to dry and then it's time to style.
You guys, so those are all of my textured wall art pieces. I really hope you all enjoyed this video. Again, you can get any size canvas that you want. You can make this way bigger or smaller, just depending on your space. I had a lot of fun making this. Let me know in the comments if you want me to do more DIYs. With all that being said, if you enjoyed today's video, if it gave you any inspiration at all, please make sure you subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, and all of my textured wall art. We will see you all in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye, guys.